harmony, the place that's called the peace that passeth all understanding. It's in everyone all the time. Just as a technicality, it's also outside everyone all the time. In fact, there's really no inside and outside. That's the way we view things. But we're going to talk about as though we have an inside. Almost everybody is intention almost all of the time. Maybe if they take a substance or they take alcohol, it can reduce a little. It's always there. Whether they're awake or whether they're asleep, there's a tension, there's a contraction. And in a natural state, it's part of survival. But in its natural state, when the tension isn't needed to survive, it drops back into stillness, into balance. And pretty well, as a species, we're out of touch with that. Everyone, almost everyone, almost all of the time, is intention. If you meet someone who's living in this, we'll call it space, there's something different about them. They're very quiet, they're very still, and yet they're very alive. And as a species, we're not in that state. There's a tension there all of the time. Now, as I say, part of that is natural. It's to protect us. It was when we were living in caves and we had to be looking out all the time for danger. But mostly it's come from our childhood. First of all, we had a bit of a tough time coming through into the world. And then we came from a protected place into, oh, isn't he or she lovely? Lights, all sorts of... That's when the contraction starts. And then this quiet, gentle being has been born into noise and danger. And the danger is exasperated by you're either wrong or you're right. And as a child, you'll keep doing things what the grown-ups called wrong. Get shouted at. Don't do that. No, no, no. So a tension builds up inside. And eventually, it doesn't go back to the resting place. It stays tense. If you want to check that out, when you're with people, observe, watch. Look at their facial expressions. Look at their body language. Listen to their voice. And then, sense them. Sense them. You're capable of doing that. You can feel how, let's call it, relaxed a person is, or how tense they are. And as I say, most people are tense most of the time. And it's not needed. The danger that the system is trying to protect itself from is no longer here all the time. But it built up this protection as a child, and now it hasn't had the encouragement to see in each moment, do I need to be that tense? So sometimes you might be telling a story that's exciting. And so you do wind up a bit. But then you'll find you don't wind down again afterwards. You stay up. When you're listening to people watch, they stay up. They're coming up from their heads. Occasionally they may drop into emotions a little bit, but even then, it's all part of the mind. It's tense. It's on. It's plugged in. And we pay for that Because the system can't work healthily in tension all the time. Everything's too tight to take care of itself. If you sit and just sit, then the body can start taking care of itself. You expand. If you're in tension, nothing can move around. The chemicals, the energy, the electricity can't move around freely. It can't look after you. If you just sit, the body starts to take care of itself. Now, even medical science is saying that the cause of most illness is stress. Now, yes, there can be an inherited tendency to something, but some people, even twins, one gets it and the other doesn't. One's tense, the other's less tense. So we make things worse, whatever the tendency is, we make it worse with tension, with contraction. A lot of our contraction and tension comes from the outside not being the way we want it to be. So we get angry, or we complain, or we're against, or tension. See if you can, right in this moment, connect with what I'm saying. Just check through the body. If you take a few deep breaths and just sit there quietly, giving yourself permission not to answer the phone, not to, just sitting quietly. Just check. First check the body. Any tension in there? You'll almost certainly find some, more in some places than others. And if you practice this, you'll start to see whether you're tight. If you're uncomfortable with sex, you'll find there's an area that goes with that. If you're uncomfortable with communicating, you'll find there's an area that goes with that. If you're uncomfortable with receiving, there's an area that goes with that. Or giving, there's an area. There's an area. If you find a tight spot, just imagine as you take a breath, you breathe into the tight spot, and it'll get a bit tighter. And then as you breathe out, it expands. And if you go through the body like that, start to find there's a different feeling altogether. There is a peace. There is a stillness. It's not a deadness. Very alive. And it's still. You might even hear a sound in your ears or feel a sound in your ears that goes with it. It could be a hum or a tingle or a whistle. And if you tune into that, melt into it, allow it to expand. That sense, that tingle, can go through the whole body. Right to your fingertips. Right to your toes. They start to tingle. And if you stay with that, you will find that the tingle doesn't end at your fingertips. Because outside of your fingertips is tingling as well. The air is not inert. It's alive. Very alive. And so are you. You're very alive. Billions of particles inside you, and they're all dancing. And the more you relax, the more you allow, the more each one finds its own dance, its own rhythm, its own frequency, its own vibration. Every single particle. And in you, when you relax, they're all in harmony. They're dancing together, producing what we call you. And if you let them all dance, and all have their own rhythm, you'll find that the air also has its rhythm. Actually, different rhythms in different places. There are energy vortexes. Some places do vibrate differently. Holy places where people go regularly changes the frequency. Some natural spots. Many of the cathedrals in Europe are built on those spots. They were built by the Sufis on those spots. That's why sometimes when you walk into a big cathedral, stand in one spot, peace. And what's happening is the peace on the outside is extra strong and it's not giving you anything. It is resonating something inside you that you already have. That peace, that tingle, is there all the time. It never goes away because there's nowhere for it to go. It's everywhere. Actually, you are everywhere. Everywhere is you. But we get so caught up in daily doings. And then we get tense and then we get tight and we're out of touch with that incredible, unnameable space, the vastness. It's here, right now. It's everywhere. So you can practice allowing yourself to feel that. And that's a good start. But the big game is in each moment. Whatever's going on, a crisis, you're there. No tension, no tightness. And then your body will take care of you. You don't have to do it. If you need to jump, jumping will happen. Because at that state, you're one with everything and everything is one with you. And let me say it again. It's here. It's now. That tingle, that vibration is not only in you. It is you. And you are it. And as you allow that sense, that dropping, you will see that what's on the inside is on the outside. What's on the outside is on the inside. And in fact, there isn't a barrier. Barrier is a form of illusion. And when you're ready, you can live that way. But you see, as soon as you want what you call your way, you'll tense up and you'll lose the feeling of connection. When you hear something you don't want to hear or something's happening you don't want to happen, tense. And then you feel out of touch. You're not out of touch, but that's what you feel. And when you feel out of touch, you get more tight, you get more afraid, and more out of touch. I know it's hard to see, but everything is perfect. You're getting exactly, exactly what you need. In each and every moment. Nothing is ever against you. It can't be against you because you are it. So it can't be against you. Whatever's going on is a gift for you. And you'll realize that gift when you stop fighting it. You stop. Feel it. Allow it. Be one with it. and it'll dissipate. So for a start, spend a little time each day. Stop, sit, take a few breaths. Acknowledge what's going on in the body and the emotions and the mind. And just imagine you're expanding. Becoming one with everything, and everything one with you.